In one of my previous videos, I showed how we can control a stepper motor using another stepper motor without using any microcontroller or complex circuitry. But with simplicity came two problems: absence of holding torque and unreliable control at slow speeds. Today, let's use two of these chips to solve the problems. Let's get started. The star of the show is this LM358 op amp, which you might remember was used to convert a stepper motor into a rotary encoder. Since a single chip can amplify two channels of signals, we will be using two of these in order to control the four inputs of a stepper motor driver. You can get complete information regarding this project, including parts list, circuit schematic, and step-by-step instructions through the link in the description. The output pins of the amplifier remain at digital high state even after the controller motor has stopped rotating. This allows the driven stepper motor to have a holding torque, hence solving the first problem. The amplifier chips are sensitive enough to pick up faint electrical signals generated by the slowly moving controller motor, thus allowing us to control the stepper motor at much lower speeds. Thus, the second problem is also solved. The circuit schematic is quite similar to the one used for converting a stepper motor into a rotary encoder. This project combines two of such circuits which use a common voltage reference LED. I would recommend building the circuit on a breadboard first and then make a PCB version to make the setup compact. If using a unipolar stepper motor as a controller, the center tap or common wire of the motor will get connected to the common pin of the amplifier. If using a bipolar stepper motor, we would need to create a virtual center tap connection using 4 1 kilo ohm resistors in this configuration. And then, this virtual center tap will get connected to the common pin of the amplifier. For now, let's connect the stepper motor's other 4 wires to the amplifier inputs in any sequence. We might need to change it later. We will then proceed with connecting the output pins of the amplifier to the input pins of the stepper motor driver. You can use any stepper motor driver with a 4-pin input interface like an L2910 driver. Also, bipolar stepper motor drivers can drive unipolar stepper motors, but that's not possible the other way around. Anyway, we will connect the outputs 1 and 2 of the first amplifier chip to the input pins 1 and 2 of the driver board, and the outputs 1 and 2 of the second amplifier chip to the input pins 3 and 4 of the driver board. Next, we will connect the stepper motor to be driven to the outputs of the stepper motor driver. We will then connect our setup to power and turn it on. Here, I have used a 5-volt adapter for this purpose. After power up, on rotating the controller stepper motor, we should see the other motor follow the movement of the controller motor. If the motor steps back and forth and does not move properly, double check all the wiring and change the sequence of the controller motor's wires connected to the input pins of the amplifier circuit. I hope you enjoyed this project. If you want to build this, you can get complete information regarding this project through the link in the description. Or you can also check a simple version of this project. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Thanks for watching.